Hello everyone, my name is Titus and today we are going to derive expression for the lens formula for the concave lens producing a virtual image. Okay, let's start. So let's first draw a diagram of our concave lens. This is the optical center, or we call the pole of the lens. Let this be the focus F, and this be the center of curvature, and here this be the focus F and the center of curvature C. So a concave lens is a diverging lens, so the focus is a virtual focus, it is not real. Why? Because the rays of light will not be converging to a point. In fact, it will look like they will be diverging away from a point. So let us place the object between the center of curvature and focus of the concave lens, and let us draw a line parallel to the pencil axis to touch the lens at point M. So for point M, the ray of light, instead of converging to a point, it will diverge away from the point. That means it will look like diverging away from the focus. So we'll draw a line from the focus like this. That means the ray of light is coming from the apex of the image or of the object, traveling parallel to pencil axis, and after passing through a concave lens, it diverges away from the point, that is diverges away from the focus. So this can be dotted line, or we can make this into a faint line. Now we'll draw one more ray of light from the, let us call this to be A and B. So our object is AB. So we'll draw a one more line from point A to point B. You can extend it backward, or else not required. So the point of intersection of the line from A to P and from F to M, there will give us the image of the object. Let us call this to be A dash B dash. Okay. So here you find that the image is quite very diminished, virtual, and it is on the same side as the object. So from here we can also write the characteristics of the image. So characteristics of image is, number one, the image is formed. Image is formed between the focus and pole on the same side. As the object. Number two, we can see that the size of the image is less as compared to the object, so we can say the image is virtual, erect, and diminished. Okay, so now let us derive the lens formula. So let us, this be the focus, since it is on the left hand side, so we can take it as minus F. U, this is the image distance from the pole, and this is minus U again, which is the distance of the object from the pole. This also we can call to be negative. So here we have F, U and V are negative as they are on the left hand side of the lens. Okay. So now from the diagram, we'll do one thing, we'll again repeat the diagram. Let us say come to the triangle ABP and triangle A dash B dash P. So in triangle ABP and triangle A dash B dash P. So let us again draw the same diagram here. A, B, A dash, B dash, P. So this whole length from here to here is minus U, and from here to here is minus P. So we can see AB is parallel to A dash B dash, and this angle is equal to this angle, and this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree, so the triangles are similar. So we can say that AB by BP, so we can say AB by BP is equal to A dash B dash divided by B dash P, or we can say from here A dash B dash by AB is equal to B dash P by BP, where B dash P is equal to minus V and B P is equal to minus of U. We can write it as V by U. Okay. Now let us come to the next triangle. If you see the diagram in here, we have one more triangle FMP, and we have a triangle A dash B dash F. So again we will plot the same diagram in here. So in triangle FMP and triangle FA dash B dash, let me plot the diagram again in here. F A dash B dash M and P. So from the diagram in here we can see that I have drawn a line parallel to the principal axis to touch the lens at point M. So we can say that AB is equal to MP. So here I can write MP is equal to AB. That means where AB is the image. Okay. So now from the diagram we see that A dash B dash is parallel to MP, and so this angle is equal to this angle. This angle is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree. This is a common angle. So we can see that again the triangles are similar. Or we can write this length from here to here. That is a focus. And this length from here to here, that is minus V. That is a distance of the image from the optical center. So here, since the triangles are similar, we can say that MP by PF, MP by PF is equal to A dash B dash, A dash B dash divided by B dash F, B dash F. But I have told MP is equal to AB, so here in place of MP I can write AB by PF. So now we can simplify this and we can write A dash B divided by AB is equal to A dash B dash divided by AB is equal to B dash F divided by PF. So where B dash F is equal to minus of F minus of minus V, and here P F is equal to minus of F. Okay. So in the previous case we have A dash B dash by AB. A dash B dash by AB is equal to V by U, and here we have A dash B dash by AB is equal to minus of F minus minus of V divided by minus of F. We can simplify this further and we can write V minus F divided by minus of F, or we can say F minus V by F. We can equate both this expression and we can write here A dash B dash divided by AB is equal to V by U, or that is equal to f minus v divided by f. We don't need this anymore. We can simplify this. So by cross multiplying, we have v into f is equal to u into f minus v. That is uf minus uv. That is vf. So uv is equal to uf minus vf. I can take out f common. I can write u minus v is equal to uv. Then I can bring f this side, and you can transfer uv on the other side on the denominator. I can write 1 by f is equal to u minus v divided by uv. Or we have 1 by f is equal to u by uv minus v by uv. I can cancel u in here, I can cancel v in here. So we have 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. So this is the lens formula for a concave lens producing a virtual image.